The OPPO 203, the Panasonic UB900, these are two of the best, not to mention most expensive 4K Blu-ray players on the market today. For months, owners and non-owners have been debating which one actually gives a better picture. In this video, we're going to do a scientific, technical comparison of their picture quality and settle the argument, at least for today. Stay tuned. Hello everyone, my name is Vincent Teo, and I'm a professional TV reviewer and calibrator at HDTV Test. In this channel, we do scientific TV reviews, video interviews, settings, tips and tricks, and also the odd unboxing video. So if you're new to this channel, please consider subscribing by clicking this button right here. Let's get on with the comparison. To kick things off, let's get something out of the way. The OPPO UDP-203 has one unassailable advantage over the Panasonic DMP-UB900 in that the OPPO will be able to support Dolby Vision HDR format following a firmware upgrade later this year. All current Panasonic Ultra HD Blu-ray players on the market, including the UB900, will not support Dolby Vision, at least that's what Panasonic engineers tell us. So if you own a Dolby Vision capable television, like a 2016 or 2017 LG OLED, you should probably choose the OPPO 203 to take advantage of the theoretical dynamic metadata benefits of Dolby Vision. As of April 2017, when this video was filmed, there are no Dolby Vision discs and players available on the market, so we can't definitively say it's superior to HDR10 4K Blu-rays until we can do a proper comparison. Okay, with that out of the way, let's start by comparing how the OPPO 203 and the Panasonic UB900 handle 4K Blu-rays. Both players have been updated to their latest firmware respectively. Version 3.29 on the OPPO UDP-203, version 1.73 on the Panasonic DMP-UB900. We've hooked up the players to the same HDMI port on the calibrated Samsung KS9500 Full Array Local Dimming LED LCD, and to compare the video output between the players, we simply swapped HDMI cables and took photos with a locked-off camera. As I've explained in a previous unboxing video of the OPPO 203, 4K Blu-ray discs are encoded in 420, so what will separate one player from the other is the quality of chroma upsampling from 420 to 422 or 444. If we put up a chroma zone plate pattern that's been mastered in 4K HDR, we can see that the Panasonic resolved more fine chroma detail than the OPPO. Now don't get me wrong, firmware update 3.29 has improved the OPPO a lot in this respect, but its chroma frequency response is still slightly behind the Panasonic. On the OPPO, the circles towards the edges of the screen became more jagged faster, whereas the Panasonic maintained their smoothness better. Can you see this difference in real-world 4K Blu-rays? Well, in all honesty, probably not from a normal viewing distance, because we're now getting into pixel peeping territory. But hey, these products are of such high quality that we have to do this to separate them. The biggest difference is seen when you watch a 4K Blu-ray that's mastered in native 4K or higher resolution with a high bit rate, for example, Lucy or Sully, on a television that can faithfully reproduce 444 chroma. Under these conditions, the Panasonic UB900 just resolves the finest colored detail that bit cleaner, smoother, and brighter. Moving on to upscaling of 1080p Blu-rays, we again used a chroma zone plate pattern from the excellent Spears & Munsell benchmark test disc, only this time it's in SDR 1080p. Here, the Panasonic kept the curves smoother too. Again, in real-world viewing, the difference is going to be extremely minor, but if you play a high bitrate Blu-ray such as Oblivion or Skyfall, the Panasonic UB900 is going to resolve the finest chroma detail just marginally better. So far, we've been talking about differences that are extremely subtle between the two players, but the next one is very obvious, and it's in the area of HDR to SDR conversion. Now, many of you will ask, why would anyone bother converting HDR to SDR? The answer lies in what produces the best image from 4K Blu-ray movies on a low brightness display, such as projectors or 2015 LG OLEDs. On these displays with low peak brightness, HDR doesn't look that good, either because there's just simply not enough dynamic range to do HDR justice, or in the case of projectors, the black floor has to be elevated to try and hit certain peak brightness. What some owners have been doing is to convert HDR to SDR when watching 4K Blu-rays, so they can still get the 4K resolution and maybe white color gamut benefits from Ultra HD Blu-rays, even in the absence of HDR. Now on the surface, the OPPO 203 is better than the Panasonic UB900 for HDR to SDR conversion, because the OPPO offers two modes. If you go into the HDR settings menu, selecting HDR off will ask the player to output SDR with Rec. 709 colors, whereas choosing strip metadata will ask the player to output SDR with Rec. 2020 colors. On the Panasonic UB900, you don't get this choice. If you turn high dynamic range output off, then the player will use the edit of the display to decide whether to send Rec. 709 or Rec. 2020 colors in SDR. And most of the time, it's going to be Rec. 709. If you want to get Rec. 2020 colors in SDR 100% of the time on the UB900, you have to buy an external device such as the HD Fury Integral to feed the necessary edit to trick the player into outputting SDR BT2020. However, the result of Panasonic's HDR to SDR conversion is much better than the OPPO's. The OPPO 203's HDR to SDR implementation suffers from a few problems, regardless of whether HDR setting was set to off or strip metadata. If you look at this test pattern that is originally in HDR but has been down-converted to SDR, the OPPO is not only crushing some shadow detail just above black, but also introducing some posterization in the gray RAM at the bottom of the screen, especially in the darker regions. The color remapping was also off, causing colors to look slightly less saturated. In real-world content, you can see these issues in this scene from the 4K Blu-ray of the movie Pan. Notice how the shadow details are missing in the boy's hair and also in the background, and how the gradations on his arm are stair-step rather than smooth. Also, if we summon the interactive graphics layer, the scene selection thumbnails appear washed out with elevated blacks, probably because of not using the correct transfer function. For comparison, here's how the Panasonic UB900 handled this exact same scene, converting HDR to SDR. The shadow detail remain intact, the skin tone gradations in the arm are smooth, and the scene selection buttons are correctly rendered. Bottom line is, if you want a 4K Blu-ray player that can accurately convert HDR to SDR, the Panasonic DMP-UB900 is our pick. So there you have it. Both the OPPO 203 and Panasonic UB900 are high-quality 4K Blu-ray players. But except for the lack of Dolby Vision, the Panasonic just does a few things better than the OPPO, especially after the latest 1.73 firmware update, which adds a 10-bit video output mode as well as a dynamic range adjustment control to make HDR content more watchable in a brighter environment. Of course, OPPO may issue a firmware update in the future that may tilt the balance in its favor, and we haven't tested the Sony X800 or the LG UP970. But for now, the Panasonic DMP-UB900 is our reference Ultra HD Blu-ray player. If you can't stretch your budget to the UB900, the step-down Panasonic UB700 and UB400 will also deliver essentially identical picture quality. If you have found this video useful, please click the like button and subscribe to the HDTV Test YouTube channel for future videos like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you the next time.